American woman, stay the F away from us. Hello, friends, cousins across the pond, cousins across big oceans, etc. So I released a video the other night that was similar to this. So the Europeans have seen it. I used the version of the AC/DC version of American Woman, and it allowed that song to be played everywhere but the United States. So I had to use Lenny Kravitz's version for, I guess, the American version. So I've gotten a lot of, first of all, you know, Great Britain has had its time. The United States has also had its time. I think it's time for our cousins across the big ocean to have their time. It's only fair, right? I mean, I've suggested this before, and everybody balked at it and is not interested in it, but, you know, I mean, we've also, I mean, it's, you know, I mean, everybody's got to take their turn, right? Right? So I just wanted to throw that in there, just to involve everybody. So what I'm going to show you is going to be some of the funniest shite you're ever going to see in your life. That's a promise. I have stated many times that while I have never met Meghan Markle, I am just 2 years older than her. I know you guys have heard this a million times, but I need to reiterate that. I've never met her, but I know her inside and out, and I'm going to prove that tonight, this morning, or wherever you are, middle of the night, morning, afternoon. I'm going to prove this to you. And again, I want you to keep an open mind at the first part to see where I'm going with everything. And then the second part that I recorded the other day, get ready to have your mind blown and laugh hysterically. And you're going to be like, oh my God, she was absolutely right. She has that spot on. So here is, and I just want to prove that I made this 3 days ago, and some of this stuff only came to my attention today, a couple hours ago, this afternoon, in America Eastern Standard Time. And some of this just came to my attention, and then there was other stuff that just came out within this 3 days. So, and then there's the copyright claim. It's like a, you know, so. And that's why some of you haven't seen it. So let's get started. So everybody's probably heard about this, but maybe some of you haven't. So Camilla Tominey wrote a story, and I couldn't pull it up because some of the stuff, and then I had to sign up for the UK. It just didn't pop up, I guess, because I'm American or in America, whatever. So this is just the headline. It'll. So Camilla Tominey wrote about the water problem at the two goon brats' Montecito Mick mansion. That's what it looks like on January 9th. And the water threat, and they won't be able to water their lawn and flat, you know, whatever. So she wrote that story. Well, that has drawn a lot of ire to Camilla Tominey, especially from one person. So then most of us have heard about the Meghan Markle and, because this story just came out, I guess it was, what's the day today? Yesterday, or the day before yesterday. An old story, but which just put out yesterday, about Meghan Markle and Harry's biblical moment, making it rain. So it was, I guess they were in Africa, and they had there was a drought and they hadn't had rain in forever, and Meghan and Harry hugged a young boy and then it started raining, something along those lines. So I find it interesting, just keep those both together in your mind, that Montecito has no rain and or has is having a water shortage, and then these two are able to literally make it rain. I know, folks, what do you want me to say? But first I need to just go over a quick two things so you have some context as to where I'm going with this. So some of you may or may, I mean, I don't know, the British might have heard of it, you know, this person or whatever. So Maud of Lancaster and the Countess of Ulster. So they were around, she was around in the 12th century. She was married to William. So, okay, so just Maud of Lancaster. And then we have the real Lilibet, which that little girl, I mean, look at that little happy baby. Her eyes are closed, looks like. But look at that cute little smiling happy baby. She's adorable. She is absolutely adorable. So we have the real Lilibet here. The real Lilibet. So something came up where I had to look up Meghan Markle and the word Lancaster, or the name Lancaster. Turns out that Meghan Markle was related to this Maud of Lancaster. Some of you may have known that, others have not. This famouskin.com, I don't know how legit this site is, but you know, whatever. I'm sure she thinks so, because I guess Lancaster was a, you know, a good family name, or a family name, and they had a castle, and they had a, you know, ancient seat, or whatever, family seat, whatever you call that stuff. So, yeah, Meghan Markle is, according to this, a Lancaster, and is related to the Maud of Lancaster. So, maybe a couple weeks ago, this Twitter account wrote some angry direct messages. Some angry direct messages to Camilla Tomini about this rain problem. Because Camilla is, wrote that story, and then she wrote about the water shortage, and then she specifically, I didn't read this story, but because I kind of can't get to it, was writing about the Duke and Duchess in their house. So this account psychotically wrote her DMs. This account's name is Lily Lancaster. And her handle's name is Real Lilibet. So, she tweets, "My conversation with Camilla Tomini, she instigated the exchange," which I didn't get that take on it, but you know, victims. "She instigated the exchange. She did not threaten me. She definitely tried to intimidate me into deleting my tweet. These were taken today, and as you can see, I am no longer allowed to respond, but I have not blocked her." Well, that's good, real Lily Maud Lancaster. For the record, well, in case anything should happen to Lily Lancaster's Twitter account, because sometimes when, you know, people might get questioned or asked or accused of being on Twitter, they usually dump the accounts. But those are usually abusive accounts, And this one doesn't seem to be taking, hasn't been seemed to taking that route until now, but we do have everything backed up now before, so in case the account gets dumped. So there's plenty of supporting evidence. So I don't know if Camilla Tomney knows who this person is, whoever's behind the Lily Lancaster account. So Camilla Tomney writes, or this woman cut this off, because you know how people do. Camilla Tomney writes, seriously, can't you even check the facts before trolling? Or is it just the pylon you're after, no matter what's the truth? No, ma'am, I am not a troll. I was just stating we have had a lot of rain. So, Lily Lancaster lives in Montecito, and she will state that. I am very sorry if I offended you. I just think facts matter. We are not in a drought. Okay. No, you've said none of this is true, when in fact the article is 100% accurate and sourced as such, yet still you've initiated a pylon. For what? Well, I have my own theories about that. Because I wrote a true story and you don't even have the decency to admit that by deleting your untrue tweet. My tweet is based in fact. Well, based in fact is different than fact. I am not deleting anything. You referenced old data. Oh, right. So as well as being a liar, you're also a hypocrite. So Camilla might know who this person is. I'm not sure. This is the notice. Montecito water customers asked to stop watering for the remainder of the year. Lily Lancaster writes, I am trying to have a decent combo. If you want to call names, you will be the only one. It was issued in December. It's continuing through January. We've spoken to the water board to confirm. You are still incorrect. Now, why is this person getting all bent out of shape if there's... So why are you saying none of it's true? What is incorrect? Your story. What part of it? Harry and Meg do live here. So Lily Lancaster lives in Montecito. That was the only part that was correct. Guardian, 4 days ago. Is this also untrue? Sorry, are you saying the Montecito Water Board hasn't issued the notice that it is actually issued? Delusional, won't accept reality. Is the water board a liar? And here we start with the classics. You need therapy and medication. Now, I will blow your mind when I start to get in the other stuff, because again, I know Meghan Markle. You need therapy and medication. Your anger will eat at you. The classics. It sounds like classic sugar boilerplate language. And you've been called out, so you're now resorting to personal insults. I didn't call you a name like you did, only facts. Okay. Well, I guess that's a fact, but everything else about the water is based in facts. Your facts are wrong, and your tweet is wrong, though. Don't you care you're both lying and a hypocrite? I'll pray for you. Now remember, I'll pray for you. You need therapy. Likewise, absolute madness and actually kind of scary, to be honest. Yes, you are. Are you like 8 years old? Now, I spoke about Meghan Markle having arrested development and she had the, you know, maturity and mind level of a 13-year-old, but Camilla... I said 8 years old. Jesus wept. Keep on trolling. Get help. Remember, get help. Yep, you do that, love. So then after that conversation, Lily Lancaster tweets this over this story and her interaction with Camilla Tomney and her saying all these, get help, I'll pray for you, you need therapy and medication, blah, blah, blah. So then Lily Lancaster seems to be emotionally worn out from this for whatever reason and emotionally attached. I am feeling overwhelmed right now. This is way too much. Now that's this tweet, the victim tweet, is a lot different of a tone than she was taking with Camilla Tominey. I'm feeling overwhelmed right now. This is way too much. My old buddy, Murky Meg, too. I hate that that well-known and documented liar has you feeling down. She is just kicking up a fuss because clearly the Camilla Tominey is a liar tag is getting to her. She must be jealous that Camilla Tominey is a middle-aged white woman. I don't know how old she is, but I'm going to say she's a middle-aged white woman who's mad that Prince Harry didn't marry her. Tag is getting to her, she's jealous and racist, and she has to resort to reporting about damn grass, when before she had a steady diet of leaks and palace scoops. Now, there have been working theories that a certain redhead, Ginger, may sometimes be behind this count, but I don't know. They are British. They are British. You can tell by the way they spell things. They don't spell things the way Americans do. And there are plenty of these, replies, but I just picked these two. So, babe, she really just has no power over you. Don't pay her any mind. You spoke your truth. Meghan Markle likes to speak her truth. Doesn't mean it's the truth. And she's known for her lies. Who is? Pay her no mind. So, just keep all that in mind. So, could Lily Lancaster, Meghan Markle's daughter is named Lily, and her Twitter handle is named Real Lilibet, and she, Rachel Merkel is related to Maud Lancaster, so then you have Lily Lancaster, the real Lilibet. So now I'm going to show you the video that I recorded the other day. Get ready because you're going to laugh and your minds will be blown because I know Meghan Markle. I've never met her, but I know her. Been around those psychos my whole life. Good evening, folks. I've got some Friday night entertainment for everybody. This is going to be some of the funniest stuff you'll ever hear. So, I have often commented on the dear Duchess and that I wouldn't let her walk down the steps behind me. Or if I actually saw her come into a room, I'd leave. If I saw her walking down the street towards me, I wouldn't turn around and have my back towards her. I would just go to the side or something. And I'm able to make these judgments because, as it's been well established, that while I'm a middle-aged older woman than her, the age difference is only 2 years. And, there's very a lot of, similarities there. And I'm an American, and I've been around women like Meghan my whole life. So I'm going to tell you a story about one of them. And I want to see if you guys find any similarities between them. And you'll see that I am able to make the judgment. The sugars will all say, "Oh, you're just jealous," and, "Oh, you don't know her." Well, no, I've never met her, but I certainly know her. I've been around them my whole life. And I'm gonna tell you about the most severe case and tell me if there are any similarities going on. So I'm going to tell you the story about my ex-boyfriend of 10 years' wife. And I have the Fuhrer up here because that may or Fuhrer may or may not be her last name. It may or may not be her last name, which is ironic, isn't it? It's very, very, very ironic. So I had first found out about her. My boyfriend, ex-boyfriend, and I, we were together for 10 years. It just didn't work anymore, and we were still friends. I still saw the dog. He had some stuff of mine. Whatever. So we ended it on good terms. It just wasn't working anymore. So when I first heard about, we'll call her the Fuhrer. When I first heard about the Fuhrer, I didn't care, but somebody showed me her on Facebook, and just like any other girl, I looked her up on Facebook, and I saw that we had 9 mutual friends on Facebook, which is, fine. Well, within a week after that, we had 276 mutual friends. She had somehow become friends with people that I went to grade school with that was in another state. So, if that tells you anything, and I thought to myself, oh boy, because I've been around them. I've been around them. Not this severe, though. Not this severe. So, whatever. That rubbed me the wrong way, but I didn't care. So then I decided my hair's dark. I decided to dye it blonde again just for the summer, one summer. And I did that in July, and then in August something happened. So that's me on the left on July 8th. My hair was blonde, and I wrote Blondie. And then next to somebody's whose n last name may or may not ironically be the Fuhrer. On August 27th, she also had dark hair, and she dyed it blonde and wrote Blondie on her picture. And then I thought to myself, oh no, we've really got a problem here. But I didn't know how big of a problem it actually was going to be. So in the meantime, my ex-boyfriend still had some of my furniture and things, and he had some things of my great grandmother's that's what I really cared about. But and I never got them back because I still went over and saw the dog and things like that. Well, understandably, he was dating this psycho. Understandably, he said, you can't see the dog anymore. I'm like, that's, all right. I mean, I was upset, but I'm like, okay, I'm gonna have the dog for 7 years. Okay. I go, well, I'm gonna need my stuff back. So he said, okay. So we go back and forth trying to make these arrangements, and then, it was anybody's busy. And I wasn't really in a hurry, but like, I wanted it back. Like, if I can't see the dog, I want my stuff back, right? So then later on, like, it gets it like a couple months, it keeps dragging on, and he stops returning my texts when I want my things back. Now, I don't know if it was because he didn't tell her it was my stuff, he was too cheap, or what the story was, but I just couldn't get a hold of him anymore. So fast forward a few more months, and somebody tells me that they saw on this psychopath, because she friended everybody I knew, well, a lot of people, 276 or whatever the number was, said, I think I saw her trying to sell your stuff on Facebook. So I went and looked at it on Facebook, and sure enough, because people had been to our house, sure enough, she's trying to sell my stuff. So I sent him a text, and I sent her a Facebook message because I didn't want her selling things of my great grandmother's that I was never going to be able to get back. So, was it ideal that I was going to talk to her? No, but I needed to tell her to just stop selling my stuff. I can't get a hold of your asshole boyfriend. So, shall we continue? So I very politely, I mean, I wasn't, kissing her, I was a little mad, but I said, so and so, my friend told me that she saw my TV stand is up for sale. So and so, owes me a lot of my furniture back, like a lot. Do not sell anything that is mine. So and so knows what it all is. I hope this doesn't have to get ugly. I messaged him too. Because I already knew that she was a psychopath. Because everybody, of all the bizarre things she was doing and trying to befriend my, she doesn't have any friends. She's a psycho, a narcissist. But, and then, on the outskirts of her, they think that she's so beautiful and so nice and, the usual. The people that don't know them think that they're so nice and sweet because that's what they portrayed themselves to be. They don't have any friends, and we know the story. So I just said, don't, I messaged him too. I need my stuff. Oh, and then, so before all this, he had told me, she's the most, he would write me, she's the most beautiful woman, girl in the world. I love her. She's so beautiful and the kind and everything. To these text messages that he was writing me, and I'm like, reading them, I'm like, is this even him writing these text messages? Like, this doesn't sound like him. So this is what, oh shoot, I keep messing up. So this is what has been described all over the place and to him, which I don't even know if he wrote the text himself, the most beautiful person inside and out. She writes back within like 30 seconds. Hi, helpful tip. When you end a relationship, besides getting your furniture right away, you should also make sure all the embarrassing and nasty photos of yourself are deleted from a shared computer, such as photos of your butthole. Yikes. If he's had it in his house over 2 years, I think it's his. Well, now granted, we weren't together for a year. So who knows whose private parts were on his computer, and what was she doing on his computer anyway, is the question. Like, what are you doing going through his stuffs to even know? So, and I had been trying to get the stuff back, so I just write, so this is what she opens up with in 30 seconds. Said, not my private part, nope. I said, I've tried picking it up and he ignores me. Why do you two want my furniture? That's effing weird. That's a narcissist thing to do. Like, take it's weird. I can't understand, like, if I had a, new boyfriend and I found out that that's his ex-girlfriend stuff, I'd be like, get this stuff out of here. But she wants to keep it too, apparently. I'm like, what is wrong with these two? So it's gonna get way worse, folks. So we went back and forth. And I said, I'll be waiting for a prompt response. Anything else? I have something. People say you look like Fiona from Shrek. She's actually a very pretty girl, but she, one could make that argument. And you have such a fat ass that someone wouldn't even be able to get in to see your nasty butthole because it's pretty deep down there. Helpful hint, go on an effing diet. See, this is what girls, we do to each other, when, anyway. Now, here's the classic. You need help, and I hope that you find some. I'll pray for you. Get help, seek help, you need help. The usual. Now, when he and I started going back and forth during all of this, she liked to take. So I just need to point this point this out again. So Lily Lancaster to Camilla Tominey of the therapy and medication, but then Lily Lancaster writes, in order, I will pray for you. Get help. I'll pray for you, number one. Two, get help. To each other, one. Anyway. Now here's the classic. You need help, and I hope that you find some. I'll pray for you. Now, I had those out of order, but does it really matter? So, you need help, I'll pray for you. From Lily Lancaster. From somebody whose last name may or may not be Fuhrer, and we'll just call her the Fuhrer, right? You need help, I hope you find some. I'll pray for you. get help, seek help, you need help, the usual. Now, when he and I started going back and forth during all of this, she liked to take selfies of herself a lot and like stick her butt out and like smile. She would take like five selfies a day. And I said to him, not that I didn't care, I said this to, be a bitch or whatever, but I'm like, and because we were on a group text message and I said, I go, does Mike not give you enough attention, so and so? I go, you better keep an eye on that because if she needs a lot of attention, that's gonna end. So we'll get to that. We'll get to that. So because I just wanted my great grandmother's stuff back, I could have cared less about that furniture. It was old. Like I didn't. But since he did that, and this is how this girl acted, I wanted every pen, paper clip, everything of mine that was back. So I had to take him to the magistrate to get it back. Well, he was mad, but whatever. So we go to the magistrate. I have all the text messages, showing that I tried to get it back, and he just started ignoring me, etc. So when the judge, this is a classic. So when the judge looks at him to explain his story, this is what he said. And his father's a lawyer. He thinks he's a lawyer because his dad's a lawyer, owns one of the biggest law firms in Pittsburgh, and like they have seven other locations. But so his defense, and tell me who you think came up with this legal defense. He said, "Your Honor, if I may, I have a new woman in my life, and she's just jealous. That's why she's trying to get her furniture." So, who's always accusing everybody of being jealous? So I got the, "You need help, I'll pray for you. I know Meghan Markle." And sh this my it's this the Duchess of Narsussex wants her stuff back because he has a new woman in his life. And I'm just jealous. We're back. So you have the get help, you need help, I hope you find some. And then the reason that I'm trying to get my own stuff back and my great grandmother's stuff back is because he has a new woman in his life and I'm jealous. That's why I want my stuff back, is because I'm jealous. Starting to see any similarities? It's going to get worse. So I had to get some movers to go there because we agreed that, it just started getting up. So I got some movers. So the movers bring my stuff to a storage unit, and I'm going to show you how it comes back. It's all broken and destroyed. Broken and destroyed. Now these movers didn't know. They're just picking up furniture. So it's all broken and destroyed. And then, I think she's about 6 or 7 years younger than me. So at the time, maybe she was 32. So then his name starts with an M. She drew a little, in a cute little girl thing, I heart M, in one of the bottoms of the drawers. And then she carved an M. It must have been however it was sitting, but that's an M. Oh, his middle name, it starts with a W, but so she carved that into my stuff, but yet I'm the psycho that needs help. Oh, and then so I told people about this. These pictures were taken, that this happened in 2017. These were just my phone when I was looking for them. I showed everybody. And, the most beautiful, wonderful person inside and out told everybody that I did this to my own stuff and that I'm crazy and jealous. I did this to my own stuff. I'm crazy and jealous just to try and make her look bad because she's prettier than I am. I swear, I'm not making it up. Now, this crazy bitch was smart enough not to touch my great grandmother's things, so I didn't even want, like I said, I didn't even want this furniture back. It was just, but because of what these two did and I just dropped it because all that narcissist wanted was more attention from me, and I wasn't going to give it to her. So I just dropped it. So that was in 2017. So then, it's going back and forth for like a year. Just her craziness and contacting people about me, but it's still at the same time. Everybody thinks she's so beautiful and so sweet because she puts cutesy pictures of herself up on Facebook all day. So in March of 2018, I had gone to Sausalito, Mexico, which is a little, like a little. It's very cold there. It's outside of Puerto Vallarta in Mexico, and I'm showing you these bigger pictures. That I took. I just had taken this picture. It was a cool place we were staying. So I just took this picture. I was young, whatever. I took this picture. I also took this picture. This was out like on the top of the condo we were staying. I took this picture, and then these two pictures went up on Facebook. And notice my nail polish there. So I had put, you can see it, it's smaller. I had put this picture on March 18th up on Facebook. It's Sausalito, Mexico. And I had also put this picture up on Facebook. So then a week or two later, a friend of mine sends me a text message and it says, "Is your Facebook open or closed?" And as I've told you, I always leave my Facebook open. That's how they were able to go through all my stuff. And I said, "Open, why?" So, oh, shoot, hold on. Well, you can see what. So, yeah, "Is your Facebook page open or locked?" I said, "Open, why?" I don't even want to know why you're asking because this girl's crazy. I mean, I knew what it was about and who it was about because she's crazy. This is how they all are, and it's going to get worse. And so then she sends me the picture, which I just pulled up. Let me show you again. So she shows me this picture of somebody whose name may or may not be Fuhrer a week or two later. Now, do you see any similarities there? Let me do a side by side here. Here's the side by side. So that's me on the left. That's her in the middle. A week or two later. Doesn't have the date there, but I'll show you the text. That's her in the middle. Then me on the left with my nail polish, and I don't know if you can see that, but her nail polish is the same. So, yeah. So, yeah, she said, I said, "I don't even want to know why you're asking." So she sends me the picture, and I said, "She's such an effing psycho stalker." And she said, "No shit, dude, it's so bad." And I said, "Her effing toenails are the same color as mine." "Oh my God, stop. Single white female. I can't." I said, "Dude, she's gonna kill me. She's giving me anxiety." Because she was. She was. And I'm not saying for any sugars out there that are listening, I'm not saying that Meghan Markle is stalking me. I'm just saying I've met girls just like Meghan Markle that use, "She's jealous all the time. You need help. They have no friends." People on the outskirts think they're so sweet and beautiful because that's what they portray themselves to be. Meanwhile, this psycho is destroying my stuff, dyeing her hair, taking pictures, just doing all her crazy stuff. So then, right after I get back from Mexico, I go to a Penguins game and I'm there with some friends. And the girl in the blonde hair, I know her. I mean, we were acquaintances. And then my ex-boyfriend had a stepsister. And we were still friends. So I was there with her because he didn't like the stepsister and we were still friends, whatever. It was no loss on either of their side, so. So we were there. And because the Führer was being such a psycho, she and I were talking about it because the Führer was also a psycho about her because she's a very pretty girl. You know, but we were both jealous of her. Everybody's jealous of the Führer. So this girl in the blonde hair overhears us talking about her. And she said, so and so, the Führer? And we're like, yeah. And she said, I know her. And we're like, how do you know her? And she said, well, she's been messaging me about my wedding, because this girl had just recently got married. She's been messaging about her wedding or my wedding, and she wants tips and everything, you know, and asking me for stuff. And me and the stepsister just looked at each other because, no offense to this girl over here, but, you know, she wasn't the most glamorous and wasn't going to have the most glamorous high-end wedding. That's a polite way to say it. You know, probably just a regular kind of wedding. Whereas the Führer was planning her wedding at the Ritz-Carlton in Naples, Florida. So the Führer is very wealthy. So the Führer didn't want any tips from this woman. She didn't want to know anything about it. She was just emailing, and they became friends to where wasn't even friends with this girl anymore. I wouldn't talk to her because of the Führer. I couldn't have the Führer even knowing the Führer was such a psycho. And I'm sure I'm just forgetting all kinds of things. So there was that. And then also when I got back from Mexico, I don't know if I want. And somebody, I think my stepsister or the stepsister took a picture of me because when I heard that story, I'm on my phone like that. This fucking, sorry to be swearing, this fucking crazy bitch is doing this stuff to me. She's talking to so and so. So now we're gonna get into the really fun stuff. So after I get back from Mexico, I had actually gone to Mexico as soon as my ex-boyfriend and the maybe her main name is or isn't the Fuhrer, but it still fits. It still fits.
It's probably more like it
After he got
is,
engaged,
maybe
well, I
not.
guess it like about 3 minutes after his little engagement announcement went out, a friend of his, well, a friend of a friend that lives in California, messages me right away. And he's like, oh my God, she's a wreck. But, and he was like, let's go to Mexico. I'm like, okay. I mean, why not? So when I get back from Mexico, the Fuhrer was not happy because she thought that my ex-boyfriend's best friend hooked that up. And then they were family friends. So the Fuhrer starts disinviting everybody to their wedding, his best friends, their mothers, she wiped out like seven people from going to their wedding to the point where, and the stepsister and her husband, because we were still friends, to the point where his father, my ex-boyfriend's father, was so outraged that they got in a fight over that because I didn't do anything. I mean, they got in a fight over that to where his father and his longtime girlfriend didn't go to their wedding either. So isolating they the ex-boy or the my ex-boyfriend's father and him still don't talk. This was almost 4 years ago. They still don't talk. So they didn't go to the wedding. Now his little brother and his wife, they didn't like the Fuhrer, but they were going to go to the wedding until my ex-boyfriend tells his brother that he's not going to be his best man, that the Fuhrer's little 12-year-old brother was going to be his best man for whatever reason. So the Fuhrer disinvited everybody. She wasn't allowing his brother to be his best man. She wanted her little 12-year-old half brother to be the best man, and my ex-boyfriend went along with it. So yeah, that was so they ended up not going. So now my ex-boyfriend completely doesn't have anybody in his family talking to him, right? So then last year at this time, the most beautiful woman inside and out, and everybody's jealous. Everybody's just jealous and lying. Come to find out, the Fuhrer has been cheating on the ex-boyfriend.
Shocking. And I laughed because I told him about all the attention that she needed, and he wasn't giving her enough because she still needed it with all the selfies and she still needed all that attention. So I was right, because I know girls like the Fuhrer and Meghan Markle. I've been around them my whole life. I know what's going on. So I find that out from her ex, the Fuhrer's ex-stepmother, who was much younger than the Fuhrer's father, because they're very wealthy, so he could have a hot young wife. She told me, and then she had also told me that the Fuhrer used to beat up her own mother and would throw her on the ground and punch her in the face and do all kinds of crazy stuff. The most beautiful, sweetest, kindest person inside and out beat her mother on a regular basis. So then she had to go move in with the dad and this stepmother, and the stepmother was pregnant, and the Fuhrer pushed her down the steps when she was 5 months pregnant. The most beautiful, sweetest, kindest, and everybody else needs to get help. So then the Fuhrer contacts everybody that this woman, the ex-stepmother, dates. I think her and they've been divorced for like 7 years. So the Fuhrer contacts everybody. The Fuhrer has several times put this woman's information up on Craigslist that she's like for, escort services. So then she has to get her phone number constantly changed and, but she's the most beautiful, sweetest. So I hope you like this story. It's Friday night. I thought I'd keep it light, because there's a lot of unlight thing, dark thing. So, whether or not Lily Lancaster at the Real Lilibet is possibly Meghan Markle, I do have some sort of American woman that lives in Montecito that's been out of shape about the rain in the Montecito house, and then an article comes out about the rain. So one could make, it's plausible and a good possibility that maybe Meghan Markle is behind the, or at least working that account. It's probably hers from what I've seen. What I would think so, in my opinion. So it looks like through a Lily Lancaster account, Meghan Markle is harassing Camilla Tominey about writing, the articles and stuff. So, and I don't know if Camilla knows that's her or not, or thinks that her. The conversation was quite interesting. So let me know your comments. I do know women at the very least. Let me know your comments. Her and that psycho that I had to deal with for a while. I haven't had to deal with her for a while. She's probably because she was cheating on him. They're supposedly getting a divorce, but I don't know. She's probably got someone else's ex-girlfriend to harass and stalk. So, looking forward to the comments. If you like my channel, please subscribe. If I were on a jury thinking that that was what was just presented, I would convict if Meghan Markle was, the defendant in this case. I would convict that yes, she is Lily Lancaster. Looking forward to the comments. Talk to you soon.